Hello and welcome to another episode of my Working with Apple series. My name is Carl Pullein and this week I'm going to go into the iPad email app, the email app that comes with all new iPads. Now, over the last few weeks, I have covered Mac OS Catalina mail. I've covered iPhone mail. So I thought I would just round everything off and cover everything you need to know about the mail app on your iPad. Now, before we go any further, I would just like to say, if you do get any value from this episode, then please help me by hitting that like button below. And if you haven't subscribed to my channel yet, and you would like to get all the latest tips, tricks, and news on anything to do with Apple productivity apps, then please subscribe to my channel. Okay, let me take you into iPad email now, which is basically iOS mail, and let me show you some of the tips and tricks that you can use with the iPad. Okay, let's get started with this iPad email tutorial. First up, if we hit the email icon at the bottom, once again, if you hold it down, you can get all the same, pretty much, things that you get with the iPhone, and it's very easy to go in. I can go all inboxes, bang, straight in. Now, I'm using an iPad Pro. This is the 2018 edition, so this one is actually very, very fast. Sometimes I feel it's a little bit overpowered, if that can be the thing. But anyway, going up at the top, again, once again, as we showed you last week with the archive icon and the trash icon, we can actually hold the button down at the top there, and again, you can trash message or you can archive message. You can hold down the folder button and nothing happens, but it does open up the sidebar where you can actually send the email. Now, moving into here, if you hold down the actual email itself, you get a few options where you can move it, reply, you can trash the message, you can move the message. So if you hit on the move, again, it will bring up the sidebar and you can move the mail there. So pretty much everything that I showed you last week on the iPhone, you can do, as I mentioned, using the iPad. Now, one of the great things about this one, I find, is when you actually create, because this is something you can't do on the iPhone, that's what I really wanted. So let's just create a new message. And what I want to do is I want to bring up my files folder. So I'm going to bring that one up here. I'm going to bring the files in here. Now, what you can do is just simply from your files, you can just pick up that and I can just drag it over there and I can just drop it into the message and it will, as you can see, import into the message. And I can do that with documents, as you can see over here. I can do this with files. I can do this with all sorts of things. Now, there are other things that you can do. So let's just see if I can drop that one. What I was looking for was to see if I've got my notes. So what I can do is I can bring up a note now. We're going to bring that one up here. Bring my notes up here, and I've got a test note that I created. Now, this is something else that you can do. I can just grab the note and I can drag the note down into here. And what that's going to do is it's going to put a text file. So it's not going to actually put an Apple note in there. What it's done is it's actually put a text file into the actual email. So there's a lot of things that you can actually do just by using the sidebar with the menu. So this is something that which is unique to the iPad. Now, I'm sure people are going to turn and leave comments in the message that there are a lot of other things that you can do. It's true. Equally, the trip I showed you last week on showing adding a icon to your email, adding a logo or something to your email, works exactly the same way on your iPad as it does on the iPhone. None of that is changed. So if you haven't seen that episode, I put a link to the top, at the top of this course. You can see that there, that's all there. But really, that's the only differences that you have with iPhone. With the iPad, it's a lot more of the dragging and dropping. And with the iPhone, you actually have to go to the application to find the file to put the file in. But here with the iPad, you can actually just create things like you want. And as I say, there's all sorts of like little things that you can do, which are absolutely wonderful. I love being able to open up like this, and I have a little bit of stuff here on the left hand side, and then I can just play around with this here, and I can mark it. I can notify me. When I get mail from Headspace, it will just give me a notification. I can mark this, and what that will do is then I can mark it as unread. I can flag it. I can move it to junk. There are all sorts of things that I can do. So you can just tap the flag and bang, that now has a flag, as you can see on the right hand side. So there are quite a lot of things that you can do. Now, one thing that I didn't show you last week, which has come in all of Apple's mail, which is being able to filter your mail. If you look at the bottom left here, and there's a button there, which means I can filter mail, if you look at the bottom, unread and read. So I can actually use that button to filter out. Now, hopefully you guys are all very productive people, so you don't actually need this filter. But if you do have a lot of email in your inbox, some read, some not read, then this is a function that you can use to move all the actual read mail and just see the in mail that you've actually got. One more thing before we finish this. If you come into an application like this, you'll see that this is a newsletter that I get on teaching. What you can do is if you hold down on a link like that, this will open the link. And again, you can actually get options to see. So I can actually see if the link is safe. And all I have to do, and again, you can drag and drop this around as well, by the way. I can just pick up that, and now I can drag that into an email if I wanted to. It's, you know, very, very easy to do. So there's a lot of things that you can do. I would suggest with the iPad particularly is you start playing around with what you can do. I've always found this, if I'm not sure about an email, I can just hold it and then I can have a look and see, yeah, this is actually going to be very useful. I can do this, you know, I can actually follow that. I can add it to a reading list in Safari. I can copy the link from there directly, and again, I can send it to an email. So there you go. Those are just some quick tips that you may want to use with the iPad. But like I say, pretty much everything that I showed you last week with the iPhone is the same with the iPad. So there you go. Hopefully you found this useful. If you do have any other tips with the iPad, then please help us all by adding those to the list, to the comments below. That would be really helpful to people watching this video. And it just remains for me now to wish you all a very, very productive week. Thank you for watching this video. Now, if you have enjoyed these Apple videos that I'm doing and you want to build your very own Apple productivity system, then please check out my Create Your Own Apple Productivity System course, which is available from my learning center and is incredible value. And it will show you how to bring all these parts together, the Notes app, iCloud, reminders, and calendar into one beautiful productivity system. Check out the course here. The details are below, and I hope to see you in the course.